on swords.
The fish have said goodbye.
It's halfway through the season, and the fleet's been brought to its knees.
What are you doing?
Not the way I wanted to start this morning at all.
And with tension at the breaking point,
fish slap the out of you if you keep it up.
Someone won't make it through the week. It's 4:30 a.m. aboard the Eagle Eye 2.
Red star in the morning, sailors takes warning.
Cold October breeze on.
Today, Captain Scotty Drabinowitz is desperate for a big haul.
Never miss yet.
All right.
Yes, sir. Got it?
After Hurricane Igor destroyed the fishing conditions.
The ocean went through a major change after the storm.
Swords have become scarce.
Let's hook!
No, no!
Not a good sign.
Just beautiful. Hopefully that's the first one and the only one tangled up.
Got it.
Another leader coming. Snarled up, tied up, twisted up, f***ed up.
Now we're in the cluster here.
Yeah, pull it up.
Shifting weather patterns have created tumultuous seas, causing each hook to come up empty and in a snarled knot.
Not the start of the day we were looking for.
Let's pray we can get through the rest of the day with no more excitement other than the fact of boating swordfish. We've got a long day ahead of us.
Oh, 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 that one was down deep, buddy.
Gear sunk, as you can see. Got to pull a mile up from down below, so there is weight. It's heavy.
After 200 empty hooks, weight on the line is welcome news.
Maybe it's a big old grande bluefin.
A bluefin tuna in the hold is like a winning lottery ticket.
Yeah, man, a nice size tuna now would be beautiful. 500, 600, 700 pound.
In 2011, a 754-pound bluefin sold on the Japanese market for nearly $400,000.
Yeah, it had to be a heavy fish.
A fish like that is exactly what the boys need to get their season back on track.
Suspense is killing me.
Hey, hey!
Don't let it get away!
Still see it? Get the throw grapple.
Under the pressure of the huge fish, the 1,000-pound mainline snapped.
Dang!
Oh, for sake.
Their only hope of recovering the tuna...
Throw it!
...is hooking the line before it sinks.
Come on! Oh, my God, that's... Your first day.
See it?
Yeah, no, it went down. I saw that. Oh, we had our chance. Blew it right there. That's a bummer. That's a bummer.
Can't believe you missed it.
Idiot.
Fish padded off our main line. It's gone.
I did it all.
Yep, that was a very costly mistake. Missed it twice or three times. We don't get paid unless there's fish in the hole, so now we're losing money. But does happen.
Call a Charlie Foxtrot. A cluster.
1,200 miles away. In Barnegat Light, New Jersey.
Here we are. Finally, home sweet home.
After a 23-hour steam, Captain Chris Clem brings the Frances Anne into Offlo, their first trip of the season.
Definitely wasn't too good of a trip. It's definitely been one for the record books.
3 days ago, deck boss Lemmy Eastburn smashed his hand.
Something on there, Lem.
I think it broke his finger. I don't know if it broke one of them or both of them, but his hand's down.
An injury could force Lemmy to sit out the next trip, a move he cannot afford to make.
At my house right now, there's my mom, my little sister, my older sister, her boyfriend, their baby, and me. There's six of us right now that I'm, for the most part, putting a majority of the roof over their head. Whatever, it's my responsibility. It's my little niche in the world, I guess.
What come, man?
How's it going, Rick?
Good, how'd everything go?
A lengthy one, weather was kind of sour, but we got through it. It was a grind.
Boat owner Rick Mears meets the crew at the dock.
Yeah, give it a little bit there, Len.
About to pop the hatches, start melting ice, and start handing fish up.
Each fish is carefully removed from the ice and weighed.
180 arrowhead pumpkin.
If it's a high-quality product, it'll be packed and distributed to various markets.
Today
is payoff day. Day we've been waiting for. Unload.
With swords at over $4 a pound, the catch will easily cover the boat's expenses. The only question is, how much will go into the crew's pockets?
Hopefully that little pile of big eyes will be worth 40 or 50 grand, we hope. 30 grand anyway.
The tuna's quality is rated by the color and the fat content of the meat.
Beautiful color.
Blue tag, 138.
The highest grade big eyes get a blue tag in them there. Yeah, it's sushi quality fish. 2,500 for him, maybe.
Last sword, here we go.
Last fish.
That's a wrap, first trip for the fall swordfish season.
21, Mom.
That's it. We're done.
We should get a nice paycheck out of this.
Is that reality? Nice. Ended up with 17,538 pounds, so not too bad, you know?
Today's offload of swords and tunas will bring in $70,000. And after all expenses are paid, each deckhand will put $8,000 in their pocket.
Pack out's all wrapped up. Now we just gotta clean up a little bit. Let's go home. That's it.
With a hold empty, the gloves come off, and boat owner Rick Mears notices Lemmy's hand.
What happened? I went to grab a snap out of Slick's hand. Got it around my finger. I went back, I hit the pole.
Can you close the snap with it or bait it
off? Yeah, yeah. I mean, I was still going. I just can't, like, pull a rope in with something heavy on it. Like, I can't leader a tuna. And I can't make a fist. It'd be hard pressed to send you out like that, though, if you saw her now.
Missing a fall sword fishing trip would mean missing out on thousands of dollars.
Who knows if Lemmy's gonna be able to go fishing. Yeah, he says he's all right, wants to deal with it when he comes in, but we gotta make the decision that's best for everybody.
coming up.
I don't know what the your problem is with me, but I'm getting sick of it. Fish slap the out of you if you keep it up.
300 miles off the coast of Newfoundland is the Hannah Boat. Captain Linda Greenlaw is at the start of 40 miles of gear.
I'm definitely feeling the pressure to put fish on the boat. I'm not used to fishing with a deadline.
The owner of the Hannah Bowden has received a lucrative offer for Linda's catch, if she can offload by the end of the week.
We stand to make possibly a dollar a pound more for our fish than we would if we don't make the deadline. If we have 20,000 pounds on the boat, a buck a pound, that's $20,000. That's a big difference at the end of the day in our paychecks.
Once this set is hauled, they'll head into offload, and the Hannah Bowden's return to the Grand Banks will be complete.
There's a lot of history that went on this deck, and a lot of tragedy that's always associated with it. The fact that we were able to come out unscathed, it's a special thing.
But the trip's not over until the last hooks come up.
Make some money.
Beeper!
The first beeper marks the start of 40 miles of main line and 1,000 hooks that have been soaking overnight.
Where is Kenny?
But not everyone has made it to the deck.
Kenny's in the rack. Nothing we're not used to.
For the last 5 weeks,
it seems like Kenny works harder trying to get out of work than he does working, you know?
Kenny's work ethic has not impressed the crew.
I don't know why he isn't out on deck, but just another Kenny moment.
Yeah, I'm gonna go wake Kenny up.
Time, it's vacation, it's over.
That's right. Hey, Kenny.
Yeah.
Time to do it.
Yeah.
Thank you.
He's just playing us. He knows that we'll pick up the slack at this point, so why is he gonna try harder? He'll get his before the trip's over.
Sick of sitting around, time to go make some money.
Over an hour late, Kenny finally makes it outside. Finally gets to work.
I like seeing Kenny bent over there cleaning fish. At least we know where he is.
If you're not working as a team and helping other people out when they need the help, that's how arguments start. That's how fights start on these boats. You know, it's coming to that boiling point.
Some guys are just period.
I'm too old to fish anymore. I won't do it.
How much did that last fish? 90, did you say?
How much did that last fish get it?
90.
90 pounds. I held something twice.
No kid, I ain't had time to write it down, kid.
Like,
I don't know what the problem is with me, but I'm getting sick of it.
Yeah, I get sick of you.
Oh, fish, slap the out of you if you keep it up.
I wanted to ask how much it weighed. He's like, I already told you twice, and I told Carol twice what it weighed. He didn't write down. He's running his mouth bent over. Good. Just sick listen to his slack back talking when he ain't doing nothing most of the time.
I already told him twice. Then he just snaps at me. I only laughed at him.
Yeah, you want to think long and hard before you punch him out, because it's just going to end up costing you money.
Well, you're likely getting any work out of him anyhow.
back every day.
No, Carol, I'm seeing it too. I just want to get through the trip, all right? And I don't want to deal with you.
I don't know. We'll see how the next few days go. Don't get better. It's going to get a whole lot worse for him.
Let him whine. Let him complain. I don't really give a...
One 100 miles to the east.
I don't really pray a lot, but I believe in the Lord, and the Lord looks out for me.
Captain Chris Hansen is steaming the Big Eye to the start of their 40-mile mainline.
And I'm pretty sure that the man upstairs divvies out what each and every person catches, and that's what I believe in.
Start hauling here about 4 o'clock in the morning. Yeah, I can't wait to bring out a couple more triples and some quads today.
I think Chompers has the swords dialed in pretty good, so I need to make some money to take care of my family. I think it's going to be a good day. I think we're going to catch a lot of fish.
The crew of the Big Eye's praying for big numbers.
Yeah, man.
After landing 2 huge swords yesterday.
There we go.
Yeah.
Nailed that pilot ball.
But something ain't right. That ain't my end beeper. Did he throw the red beeper on the end or what?
I don't know.
Damn, man.
We got our gears a little bit messed up this morning. We can't quite tell which beeper is on the end. Got to get on that right end so when you start hauling, it'll all come in the boat smooth.
My sat beepers tell me where my gear is, at what time it's there, what direction it's moving. I depend on that information from them sat buoys. I depend on the information to be right.
The buoy that signals the end of the gear was put somewhere in the middle of the main line, leaving Chompers no way to find the end of his line.
When the beepers ain't in the right order, it's hard for me to know where all my gear is. It costs me a lot of time.
What did we do wrong?
That's what I'm telling you. That's our end beeper right there. But it isn't. It isn't. So it's up royally.
It's Matt's job to set out the beepers in order. Chompers make sure the whole crew pays for the greenhorn's mistake.
We can't do their job, man. This is crazy, man. I mean, this is up. It's a joke, man. And it's man, it just cost us 2 hours. Because of what? Because we're up, man. I mean, it's just, it's bull, y'all. I take my job a little bit seriouser than this, you know? Anybody tell me what our end beeper is? Y'all.
That's pathetic is what that is.
Until the crew finds the end of the gear, fishing is shut down, and lost time comes out of everyone's wallets.
I tell you one thing, this better not happen again.
You gotta blame somebody. Might as well be me.
Absolutely, just not the way I wanted to start this morning at all.
In the middle of the North Atlantic, the crew of the Big Eye is losing valuable fishing time thanks to the greenhorn's rookie move.
Chasing stuff, making mistakes, you know, it's a waste our time. We waste time. Time is money, money's time.
We're hunting for our end the main line so we can start hauling back this morning. Somebody threw the wrong beeper at the end. So we're not sure on which beeper we should be looking for. It's gonna be a long day. I'm not happy, nobody's happy.
By mid-morning, the crew finally spots the beeper at the end of their main line. Chompers is going to make the greenhorn pay for his mistakes.
Smoke that leader, Matt. You boys can handle that.
It's easy to point the finger at the greenhorn. You're supposed to know it all already.
Hey.
Yeah.
I need one person to clear this from the hauling station.
Bull.
No, don't you grab that. What are you doing? No.
Captain Bust at him. Not a greenhorn's pissed off.
All these dude.
I hate when somebody don't do what I tell them to do.
And to make matters worse.
It's a joke.
Hooks are coming up empty.
It's all coming in the boat, don't stop.
After 3 hours and 500 empty hooks.
There's a sword!
The crew has their first sword of the day on the line.
Matt, one man, one gaff. You know, you got two hands, put both of them on your gaff. Keep your eye on it. We're in the deal of getting them in the hole, so don't be around. Copy?
Prick. Swap with me, Scott. I'm up.
Get him.
Not in the belly.
I know.
Stick that.
Drop it.
Matt gaffs the sword in the midsection. A rookie mistake that hurts the value of the fish.
That fish up. Greenhorn Matt. What a day. When the
The damaged sword is all the crew brought in with today's haul. And for the greenhorn, it could be the end of the line.
I don't like screwing up. You know, I screw up a couple few times, get chomped, pissed off at me, yells at me. Makes me look bad. I don't like looking bad.
It's not easy what they do. I'm not gonna say that it is. It'll break them right down. Matt made it four sets in a row, and it ain't enough. It ain't enough.
1,200 miles to the southwest.
Lemmy's not here.
I did tell him to go to the doctor.
And when this is all done, then we'll figure out where we're headed.
Captain Slick is just 24 hours from the start of his second trip. But 2 miles away.
I tell you, my finger doesn't feel any better than it did the day we got in. Probably feels a little bit worse, actually. Slick made me go to the doctor, so we'll find out here in a couple minutes.
Don't worry, bud.
How's it going?
Does it hurt? Everything bends.
Now, this one bends pretty good.
Yeah.
This one bends pretty good. Make a fist.
That's where it stops.
Right. So that's where Mike's going to work on that. Mm-hmm. Unfortunately, Len had come and see us about 2 weeks late. It's a break that can cause a lot of long-term problems in terms of stiffness. One of the things that we worry about with people with these kinds of breaks is that they may never be able to make a full fist. And when are you guys going back out again?
Oh, the boat's going out again tomorrow.
There's always a possibility that the fracture could move to the point where we would have to open it up and fix it.
How long till I can go?
Probably, I think, in about 4 to about 6 weeks.
It's just more stress on my shoulders.
Can't make any money just sitting around doing nothing.
Miles southeast of Bay Bulls.
We are steaming to Newfoundland to unload our fish and get ready for another trip.
Captain Linda Greenlaw's first trip of the season is coming to an end.
A percentage of our catch is going to a supermarket chain in New England, and we're getting a premium price.
You know that we're heading to the dock. We've got that special market we have to meet, and we're going to get top dollar for our fish.
I can't wait to get in tomorrow, get unloaded, get to take a few days off, get bait, get fuel, groceries, tackle, head back out and do it again. One more trip this season.
Good
be all over. I can't wait.
But with the rest of the crew frustrated by Kenny's performance, Linda needs to make a decision.
Well, I have been sort of aware of this situation for a couple of days and probably shouldn't have waited to mention it, but I just wanted to get through the trip, you know, without sort of any confrontation or problems.
Yes.
I can't take you this trip. But I wish that I...
No, that's not a problem.
It is what it is, right?
I understand that.
Well, I think Kenny's reaction was, I think he took it well. I said, okay, well, I guess you can't make this trip. And he said, okay. A lot simpler than I thought it would be, but it's not my favorite part of the job.
After only one trip with Captain Greenlaw, Kenny's time on the Hannah Bowden is over.
Well, Kenny's not gonna make next trip with us. So we have like as a group to, I mean, I like some input from you guys about whether we want to go shorthanded or get another guy. I would make the decision myself, but if we go shorthanded, it's not me that's doing the extra work.
Not much we can do with it,
you think shorthanded's what you'd vote for?
Yeah.
Okay.
Whatever, it don't matter. I've been shorthanded before.
Yeah. Good then. Don't have to worry about finding a guy.
For seven more of us, this truly would be your last supper, Kenny.
A 100 miles to the east.
Well, today's been a very long day. It started off relatively discouraging, I would be the word.
The crew of the Big Eye is working late to make up for Matt's rookie mistakes. They're not happy about it.
Give me some greenhorn business.
It's where you separate the men from the boys. He's got a lot more stepping up to the plate to do before he can show me that he can handle this.
To remind him why he's out there.
Hey, baby. How you doing?
Matt makes an expensive satellite phone call home.
Right now, it's not looking too great. Yeah. Nah, it's been pretty tough. Laid four sets down now, and we only have a handful of fish. Probably have, I don't know, 13, 14 fish. Yeah, it's been tough. Yeah, I don't know when I'm gonna be able to, send any money. You know? Yeah, I'm trying my best. Well, I love you and I miss you and can't wait to see you and get off this boat and come home. But tell the boys I said hey and I love them. All right. I love you too. Bye.
Coming up.
Solid green water went through the boat and just took everything with it.
The tragic tale of one fisherman who never made it home.
All of a sudden, you realize there's also two guys in the water.
300 miles off the coast of Newfoundland.
Look how white the sunset is. Red sky at night, sailor's delight. That ain't a red sun, that ain't a red sky.
Captain Scotty's feeling the pressure to find the swords and fill the Eagle Eye 2's 70,000-pound hold.
We're not really setting the world on fire with fish because we're not making any money. And the fish have said goodbye. It seems like we've been behind the eight ball the whole season, so we're all hoping for fish.
Everybody wants to win. I'm sure Chompers wants to be on top. I'm sure Francis Ann wants to be on top. Linda wants to be on top. All of them wrote to beat us. top boat for the past 2 years. It's a good year for him to try, as the Grand Banks ain't very grand.
We've been fortunate enough to kind of come out on top here the last couple of seasons. Love to keep it up, but unfortunately, nobody ever stays king forever.
But after 20 years of fishing the Grand Banks, Scotty knows there's more than money on the line.
We live a pretty harsh life out here. And you really never know when, you know, day to day what's gonna happen. I worked on the Hannah Bowden for a short time when Bob Brown was the captain of it. A local kid, name was John Bakarowski. He took my place on the boat. He was just a young kid. You know, it's a shame. Still, it's not easy to talk about. You know? I guess it'd shake anybody up when one of your friends gets killed.
In September of 1985, we left to go fishing on the Grand Banks from Bay Bulls, Newfoundland. Tommy Porter was there, Kevin Luff was there, and John Bakarowski was there as well. We were probably into the trip, say 7 days fishing maybe, and started blowing, you know, 60, 70 mile an hour and probably 20-foot seas.
It was rough out. It was just part of the job back then. You just got up and went out and worked. Some days it was nasty, some days it was nice.
These are the boys here.
1 minute they're quitting, the next minute they're dancing.
But for young deckhand John Bakarowski, it would be his final voyage.
John was funny, laughing all the time. Smile, he had a nice smile. Mm-hmm. Very friendly guy, do anything for you. Mm-hmm. Loved the ocean. Just wanted to go fishing.
So we were hauling along and, you know, I was working up on the rail with Tommy. And, you know, all of a sudden, we looked behind us and there's, you know, it had to be a 30-foot wave. It just broke over the back of the stern of the boat. And it filled the whole boat up, rail to rail, with water. After you hung on for that one, then you looked up and there was another one just as big.
Solid green water went through the boat and just took everything with it. It looked like a shipwreck behind the boat. So much stuff was floating there. All the tide buoys, spunjacks, beeper buoys, fish. There wasn't anything left. All the gas snapped off the rail.
All of a sudden, you realize that, yeah, there's stuff floating in the water, but there's also two guys in the water.
John and Kevin Luff just floated right out with the wave. And every time a wave went by, said it was like a wicked undertow and just sucked them right down.
They'd go under and then they'd bob up, but every time they came back up, they were getting further and further apart. So obviously, if you're running the boat, and you have two separate targets that you have to go to, you can't go to both of them at the same time. So at that point, you have to make a decision. Started steaming towards Kevin, because at the time he was closer. And I ended up throwing the life ring to him.
Kevin was lucky, because when he came out of one of those troughs, the life ring was there. We grabbed on and we had to pull him all the way around to the swordfish store because couldn't pull him over the rail.
Once Kevin was on board, then obviously the next goal was, you know, to get John on board. You know, he'd go under for 20 seconds, and then all of a sudden you'd see them get to the surface. But by that point, now the next wave's on top of you. So by the time we got into position to actually do anything, he was already underwater.
John was, we saw him sinking down, waiting, hoping he was gonna swim or something, but never happened.
At that point, you could just, you know, see a little orange in the water. And that's the last we saw of John.
All that afternoon and everything until dark, we kept waiting around. And you know, we didn't know whether he was gonna float back up or, you know, what. Nothing, so. That was that. John was just gonna turn 21, I think a week later. Nice kid.
On a Hannah boat on that trip, 7 people went fishing, 6 people returned home. My brother John was the one that was lost at sea. I never believed John's not coming back. There is no death certificate for someone lost at sea. There's no body. There's no finality. There's no goodbye. We miss him.
Halfway through the season, the Francis Anne and Eagle Eye 2 are neck and neck. But the Big Eye is still floundering. And it's the Hannah Bowden that takes the lead.
23 days at sea, 30,000 pounds of swordfish, many miles of salt water, lots of pounds of mackerel. We're tied up.
Feels good. I'm gonna get on the dock here now for the first time in 28 days.
For the first time in 15 years, Captain Linda Greenlaw has landed the Hannah Bowden at the dock with a hold full of swords.
It's gearing up, getting ready to do the offload. Make a paycheck.
Rod's gonna be sort of cherry picking some fish off the top of the trip for his special market that he has.
I'm here to select some fish that Linda has put my name on so we can get it to the specialty markets throughout the United States and the best restaurants.
The special market buyer is willing to pay a premium price for first pick at Linda's catch.
The very top of the trip's on the deck now.
One thing I like is the body shapes. Like, those are really fat fish.
Glad you like them.
And specialty markets will absolutely love it.
This fish all made like money, man. Right now, we're talking about money.
Whoever gets these for a seafood dinner is gonna be awfully happy.
Okay, Linda,
what's the verdict?
31,123, that's everything.
31,123. Nice.
That's tuna and maple.
Excellent, thank you so much.
No problem.
So, we ended up a little more than we thought. We had 31,1.
That's right.
That's right, Harry. This trip was a huge success. I'm really proud of my crew and love this boat. I'm ready to go out and do it again.
Thanks to the special market buyer, Linda gets a high price of over $5 a pound. And each crew member pockets $9,000 for this 3-week trip.
Trip, I love sword fishing. I love sword fishing with Linda, but it kind of sucks actually to get off in the middle of the season.
It'll be the last paycheck from the Hannah Bowden for Kenny Puttister.
I just packing up some of my last bit of gear. I got to board the boat, my sleeping gear and that. Oh, I hate to pack my bags on any boat and leave it in the middle of the season. I usually fish out seasons. Kind of sad. It was the first trip I made on the boat in 16 years. I was hoping to make 2 trips, but unfortunately, I won't be making this next trip.
1,200 miles away in Barnegat Light, New Jersey.
fingers busted up pretty bad. I need surgery on it. Not too happy about it, but I'm gonna suck it up for this trip and then go get surgery. I guess that's all I can really think to do. Need to make money, need to go fishing.
Lem, come on inside. Lem, I hate to be the bearer of bad news, but I think you should stay home and get your frickin' finger squared away, because I don't want to see you go out like that. It wouldn't be good for anybody, you know? So, I mean, I thought about it. I really can't with a good conscience send you out there and expect you to do your job 100%, and it's a hard decision to make, but I think it's one that's best for all of us. Breaks my heart to tell you you can't go, but it's just the common sense. I mean, it's kind of a no-brainer. Coach's taking me out of the game. It sucks losing Lemmy. I mean, he's been on the boat now for, I don't know, 3-4 years, whatever it's been, and he's a big part of our crew.
It hurts, but you know, I finished out last trip all right. But it's not my call. That's it for me. I'm done.
To fill Lemmy's spot.
Bates fell. Let's go.
Owner Rick has called in his nephew, Dan Mears Jr., a young veteran with experience on the Francis Anne.
It sucks that he's out, but they need a guy, so I'm here, ready to go. Hopefully we'll get some good fishing.
It's kind of depressing to see everybody getting ready and my home is leaving and I'm not going with it.
I mean, I sleep on there almost 300 nights a year. It's more than just a boat to me. It's not just a place to go work. That's my home.
Get out of here, man. Throw them all off, pivot it off, bow, get the stern away from the dock. Second trip, boarding at late departure. We're out of here.
See you, Lyle.
See you, Dan.
See you later, cousin.
Get better, man.
See you later, man.
So my main guy Lemmy's not here with me, which is, that's the hardest part, not having him on the boat right now, but we will overcome. You know, the boat's got to go out, we got to keep on fishing, the operation can't stop, still have a solid crew. Now it's just up for me to keep them solid by catching some fish and keeping them busy. That's my job, you know.
All I've done for the past 3 years is go fishing on this boat. That's it. Now I can't go. I don't know what I'm gonna do.